Today, Marvel is a household name. With popular heroes like Spider-Man and Captain America, to Iron Man and Thor, you'd be hard-pressed to find someone who hasn't heard of Marvel and their cast of spectacular heroes. Marvel has grown into a worldwide sensation, dominating the comic, film, and even television and toy markets. As with all greats, even Marvel had their humble beginnings. I'm Warren Lewis, and today I'll be taking you in the vast and amazing world of Marvel Comics. Beginning in 1933, Martin Goodman, a pulp magazine publisher, founded his company Timely Publications. Goodman worked with Western pulp magazines for much of his career, but wanted to expand into the growing comic book industry. Timely's first publication was Marvel Comics No. 1. This breakthrough publication was a hit and introduced characters still used by Marvel today, like the Human Torch and Namor the Submariner. With the outstanding success of their first issue, Timely was able to greatly expand its staff and its comic endeavors. They hired on Joe Simon and now famed comic artist Jack Kirby, who together made the iconic hero Captain America. Goodman also hired his wife's cousin, Stanley Liber, in 1939. Starting as an office assistant, Liber quickly rose up to the ranks of writer and editor. Not wanting to be associated directly with dorky comic books, Liber began writing under a pseudonym, Stan Lee. During the time of World War II, superheroes were symbols of the American dream and an inspiration to all. But after the war, these heroes took a major fall from grace, and so did Timely Publications. Goodman reworked his company into Atlas Comics in the 1950s. Instead of stories just about superheroes, the company made a wide variety of comics, from horror and romance to war and even Bible stories. The company followed popular tropes to ensure they would make a profit and avoided trying to make an innovative impact on the market. There was an attempt by the company to revive some of their classic heroes, but in the end, they all fell flat. In 1961, now-renowned writer Stan Lee had an idea of how to revamp their classic heroes for a modern audience. The company was under duress, especially with how their rival, DC Comics, was able to successfully relaunch a new line of heroes. These reboots were all published under the now iconic name of Marvel Comics. Lee thought that their superhero comics should diverge from childish tales and focus on a more mature audience. Other employees followed in Lee's footsteps and worked to break the tropes commonly found in comics of the era. Heroes in Marvel comic books were flawed and commonly fought against those seen as enemies in American culture, such as communists and the Viet Cong. In other superhero publications, the heroes were always perfect and rarely fought outside of homeland disputes. It was at this time when Marvel created their most iconic heroes, like Spider-Man, Thor, Hulk, and the X-Men and the Inhumans. In 1968, Marvel Comics reached a massive national popularity, selling over 50 million comics a year. Goodman knew it was time to hand control over to someone that would better handle his company's future. Goodman sold Marvel Comics to the Perfect Film and Chemical Corporation and stayed on as publisher and promoted Lee to editor-in-chief. Goodman eventually severed ties with Marvel, and the company stood on top of all the way through the 70s and even into the 80s. They managed to keep success with new storylines featuring their most popular heroes and making massive crossovers with Secret Wars and the Contest of Champions. It wasn't until the 90s when Marvel took another devastating hit. Many of the company's top artists and writers left to form their own company, Image Comics, famous for their Spawn comic book. Marvel also lost out to DC for much of the decade in sales numbers. They attempted to break out of their dry spell with a Heroes Reborn reboot, but in the end it did not sell well. The company struggled slightly through much of the 90s and early 2000s, but a major deal just around the corner brought them back into the limelight. Entertainment giant Disney acquired Marvel Comics in 2009 for $4 billion. This set in a whole new wave of merchandise and licensing deals that would be a major income boost for Marvel. Disney produced many animated shows for Marvel, and in turn, Marvel produced numerous comics and graphic novels for Disney's IPs. Under Disney, Marvel had many reboots, including Marvel Now in 2012, All New, All Different Marvel in 2015, and the most recent Marvel Legacy reboot in 2017. Not to mention, Marvel has released a decade-long franchise of critically acclaimed movies featuring some of their mightiest heroes to date. As you can see, Marvel has come a long way from the timely little publication it once was. From dime comics and magazines to billion-dollar feature films, it's easy to see their outstanding cultural impact. Will Marvel's influence ever reach its peak? It's hard to say, but one thing's for sure, the heroes we know and love will be around for a long, long time.